Help the Knights of Columbus help kids. Can they drive today?
I'm Igor Smith.
And I'm Witch Ward.
And today on Kidding Around, we have a special Halloween show for you.
We'll find out how to make some chocolate chip pumpkin squares. We'll see some decorated pumpkins and special window decorations.
We're going to find out all about bats and tarantulas. We're going to see a special Halloween dance and lots, lots more.
So be sure and stay with us for our special Kidding Around Halloween celebration.
You said it.
Kidding Around will return after these messages.
Find out what's next in video games as George Lucas joins forces with Atari. Video Games Magazine also previews 16 new cartridges.
In Uptown,
we're proud to work together.
In Pilsen, estoy orgulloso de Casaslan.
I'm Katie Donnellan. I'm proud of Rogers Park because we've kept our ethnic heritage strong.
Yay! Neighborhoods, an Emphasis 82 campaign highlighting community interests.
There's only one Capri Sun. It's great tasting fun when you punch open one.
Oh, Mr. Keebler, my prince is under a spell. To snap him out of it, I must find a chocolate chip cookie with incredible richness.
How about our Rich and Chips?
Are they really rich?
Rich taste in every bite. We elves make sure the cookie part is deliciously rich before we add rich, chocolatey chips. So the cookie is as rich as the chips.
Mmm, royally rich. These should break the spell.
Thanks, Keebler. Delicious.
Uncommonly rich Keebler Rich and Chips.
The Legoland Castle. You build it for action. You can build the castle, then open up the wall, and pretend the knight jumps on his horse when he hears the bugle call.
The action's up to you.
Or you can pretend the guard calls out. The tournament will begin. So you lower the drawbridge, send out the knights, and hope that your side wins.
The action's up to you.
The Legoland Castle from the Legoland Collection comes with everything you see here from Lego Systems.
Now back to Kidding Around.
Well, it's Halloween weekend. Just a minute. There, that's better. Now I can talk right. Halloween weekend, are y'all ready?
Mm-hmm.
You look ready.
Oh, yeah.
We're ready, too, and we're going to start things off today with 12-year-old Karen Smiley, who flew in on her broom from Grange Park to show us how to decorate windows for Halloween.
And Karen's 10-year-old brother, Scott Smiley, is going to give us some ideas for decorating pumpkins.
Hi, how are you today?
Hi.
You guys look great.
Yeah.
Well, Karen, we're going to start things off, and we're going to talk about windows and decorating. Let's move back here. This is a finished window. This is great. We have a little ghost up here wishing us happy Halloween and a funny-looking witch. How do you do this? And what do we need? I guess, first of all, what kind of supplies do we have to have?
First, you need your paintbrushes. I use a thin and a thick.
Okay.
Then you need your tempera paints.
Now, what kind of paint is that?
Tempera. And you can. The nice thing about it is you can wash it off with water.
Ah, very important. What else?
And then you need something to get your idea off. I use napkins and paper plates.
Sure, here's a great little idea there. I guess you could use a book or a magazine or just anything that gives you an idea. We also have some cleanup stuff.
Yeah, and a bucket of water to rinse your paintbrushes off in.
Ah, okay. And then you need a window. We just happen to have one right here. Now, you've already got this started, don't you?
Mm-hmm. I have the outline on it.
Why do we have that on there already?
So that it's easier to paint. When you have that on, you know exactly what you're going to be doing.
So sort of a guideline.
Mm-hmm.
All right. You want to get the paint ready? Let me get this out of your way. Okay. What are we going to use?
We're going to use some orange paint to paint the moon.
All right. Let me take the back off of the window pane here. I don't know how easy that is to see at home.
And then you take your orange paint and you just paint inside your line.
Ah. Now, I guess the nice thing about this is if you make a mistake, since it's washable with water. You can just wipe it right off,
mm-hmm.
huh? Neat. Oh.
You always have to paint on the inside of your window.
Now, if you're using letters, you also have to do it backwards, don't you?
Anything you do will be backwards.
So you better learn how to spell it the right way. Now, do you do this just you and Scott together, or?
We each invite a couple of friends over and make a party out of it.
Well, what a neat idea. Thank you for sharing it with us.
Mm-hmm.
Scott has brought in several pumpkins decorated with food and other household items. Well, why don't we take a look at some of your ideas first?
This is a totem pole with a pole in the middle so they keep them together.
Oh, I see. And you have mushrooms for ears.
Yeah.
What's that, for the nose?
Pecan.
Pecan, that's a good idea. And what about the tongue down there?
It's a hollowed out red pepper.
Oh, that's a good idea. That's, how do you hold all this stuff on?
With either pins or toothpicks.
Oh, it just depends on the size,
yeah.
Right? Okay, well, what about this one?
The dragon. You can use green paint if
yeah.
you want.
Yeah, green for the dragon, right?
Yeah.
Okay, well, what about these eyes?
Styrofoam balls with crayon apples in the middle.
Oh, I see. And you use pins to hold that on, right?
Yeah.
Well, what about that mouth? That's really...
Well, it's made of a half of an egg carton with a pin stick through the teeth for...
Oh, and you have several teeth, right?
Yeah.
And what about that shiny? Is that a tongue or what?
Yeah.
That's a tongue? What do you make that out of?
Red tinfoil.
Oh, that's neat. Well, what about this guy?
It's like he's a freezing guy outside.
Oh, yeah, I see. He has green pepper for ears, right?
Yeah.
And that's held on with pins, and he has glasses.
Mm-hmm.
And what's this? Another kind of pepper?
Yeah.
What do you use for the frost?
Icing.
Icing, and I see he has a little hat and scarf. Well, that's really clever. How do you make these? How do you make
well,
the design?
You make a design with crayon or marker. Then you just cut it out with a sharp knife.
Oh.
You should have someone help you cut it.
Yeah, shouldn't do it alone, right? Yeah. Well, what about this pumpkin seed recipe?
Well, first you soak in salt water overnight. And then you put a tablespoon of butter and salt on. You cook it for about an hour, and you check every 15 minutes to see if it's crisp.
Oh, well, thanks a lot for talking with us today, and your costume's really great. Have a happy Halloween.
Thanks, Scott. Thanks, Karen. Thanks for helping us celebrate. We're still painting our window, and when we finish this up, we're going to have some dancers. Four dancers from Diana's Dance School in Chicago. They're going to do a special Halloween dance for us.
They'll perform to Eye of the Tiger. Now here are Diana's dancers.
Name and age.
Doreen Pantone, I'm 12 years old.
Doreen, how long have you been dancing?
3 years.
Oh, ready?
Jamie Skrezyna, 12 years old, and I've been dancing for 8 years.
Catch your breath there.
Nadine Humay, and I'm 12 years old, and I've been dancing for 5 years.
Thanks, Nadine.
And I'm Tom Fagan, 13 years old, and I've been dancing 11 years.
Ah, the old pro here. Two old pros. Oh. Have you decided what you're going to be on Halloween?
Well, maybe I might be a ghost.
A ghost?
A ghost.
All right.
Might be a witch.
A witch?
haven't figured it out yet.
She hasn't figured it out. That ought to be in it. Well, this costume's real nice, too. How about you?
A lion.
A lion. You have a very pretty mane already.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for helping us celebrate Happy Halloween. I hope you have a very happy Halloween.
You too.
Jenny?
Today I'm going to tell you some Halloween news from a few of your favorite celebrities. Actor Michael Damian of TV's daytime drama The Young and the Restless always dressed up like a ghost when he was a kid. That was his favorite costume. Facts of Life star Nancy McKeon says that her favorite kind of treat is a gooey popcorn ball. And actor Peter Barton of TV's Powers of Matthew Starr says his favorite thing about Halloween as a kid was the look on people's faces when they saw him in his costume. He was dressed like a giant tooth. Another Facts of Life star, Lisa Welchel, says she really goes nuts over those little teeny candy bars everyone hands out. Actor Ricky Schroeder from TV's Silver Spoons loves to go to the houses that give out fruit and packages of raisins and healthy stuff. Joni Loves Chachi star Erin Moran says that she used to be one of those rotten kids who did tricks on people if they didn't give a good out treat, but nothing real bad. And actor Rad Daly says he still goes out trick-or-treating. He just hunches over so people don't think he's too old. He says dressing up as a ghost helps pull off the stunt, even though he's 17. And that's all our Halloween celebrity news for today. Steve?
Halloween is a magical time of year, so we thought we would listen to the hit song, You Can Do Magic, by the very popular group America. The catchy pop sounds of America started almost 10 years ago when Gary Beckley and Dewey Bunnell started the group while they were still in high school. And by the time they graduated, they had already become international music stars, which isn't too bad for two 18-year-olds. Some of their big hit songs have been Horse With No Name, Tin Man, and Ventura Highway. Let's listen now to the musical magic of America and their latest hit, You Can Do Magic.
I never believed in things that I couldn't see. I said if I can't feel it, then how could it be? No magic could happen to me. And then I saw you, I couldn't believe it. You took my heart, I couldn't retrieve it. Said to myself, what's it all about? Now I know there can be no doubt.
Magic by the supergroup America.
When we come back, we'll be making you some chocolate chip pumpkin squares. We'll see some neat animals and lots more.
So stay with us for lots more Halloween fun today on Kidding Around.
Kidding Around will return after these messages.
UNICEF volunteers make a world of difference. Their schools, churches, clubs, where they work and where they play. Helping children is a part of their lives. Join them this fall by organizing a UNICEF benefit or activity in your community. Your help can mean nutritious food, health care, and basic education for the neediest children in over 100 developing countries. You can make a world of difference this October. Support National UNICEF Day, October 31st.
Traffic patrol, a keen machine for riding around and in between. Just hop on, step on the pedal, and you're riding on the traffic patrol.
Traffic patrol is battery powered. Pine's rechargeable battery is included. Adult assembly is required.
Here's Pine, little rubbing outside for a ride with the traffic patrol.
Pine's Traffic Patrol and Pine's Little Rosie, each sold separately.
Just watch us fill your days and nights with laughter and with pure delight. We'll take you places where you'd really want to go. Watch Inside Out, just pack the screen. Kidding Around, View Magazine, and news that hits home every day in every way.
We're Channel 5, just watch us, Channel 5. You'll love us, Channel 5, just watch us now. People's Court, watch us now. Family Feud, watch us now.
Now back back to kidding around.
Halloween. Say, what's your favorite thing about Halloween?
I think I have to say the candy.
Yeah, all the junk, right?
All right. How about you?
Yeah, I think hands down the food wins. I look forward to having all the good stuff. And speaking of good stuff, 12-year-old Michelle Morey from LaGrange Park is going to show us how to make chocolate chip pumpkin squares. Hi, Michelle.
Hello.
You're even dressed as a pumpkin.
Right.
That's great. Well, this is what we're making today, right? These are the pumpkin squares, and what do we have next to them here?
The raisin pumpkin cookies.
Raisin pumpkin cookies. Boy, those look good, too. But we're going to get the recipe for chocolate chip pumpkin squares.
Right.
And first of all, I guess you need to tell us what ingredients we need.
Okay, in here we've got 2 1/4 cup flour, 2 1/4 teaspoon baking powder, 1/2 teaspoon baking soda, 1 teaspoon cinnamon, and 1/2 teaspoon nutmeg.
Okay.
4 beaten eggs, 1 cup of granulated sugar, 1 cup of brown sugar, 1/2 cup margarine, 2 cups pumpkin filling, and 1 cup chocolate chips.
Oh, yum. All right, that's a lot of ingredients. Once we have them all gathered together, I see we have some different utensils here. What are those?
We've got a 9x13 pan, a spatula, bowl, spoons, and a mixer.
And a mixer. All right, once we've gathered all the necessary items together, how do we put it together?
You grease your pan.
Okay.
Then you take the flour, baking powder, baking soda, cinnamon, and nutmeg, and set that aside.
Okay, that's all mixed together.
Right.
We push that off to the side.
Then you take your 4 eggs and beat them, which I've already beaten.
Okay.
And put them in your bowl.
All right. In go 4 beaten eggs.
Then you take your sugar and add that.
All right.
And your brown sugar. Then your shortening.
Sort of melted on the...
Right.
Can we just sort of scrape that in there? Yummy! There you go. All right.
Okay. And the pumpkin filling.
Okay. Yeah! And then we get the old mixer, huh? Probably be a good idea if Mom were around when you're putting on the mixer.
Right. You need to mix that together.
All right.
Then you slowly add your flour mixture.
Until it's really well mixed, right?
Right.
Now we're gonna not mix it as well as you would at home in your own kitchen, but this has all gone in there and we've mixed it up real good now. Okay. There we go. Here, let me take that from you.
And when that is well mixed, you get, and the batter looks like this.
Ah, yeah, that looks good.
Then you take your chocolate chips.
Ah, the best part.
And you stir those in.
Okay. Oh, yum. Can you add more chocolate chips or is that just enough?
You could add more if you want, but I think this is plenty.
Okay. I happen to like chocolate chip a whole lot. Okay.
And you take your batter and pour it into the pan.
There we go. Oh boy, you want to hold this? There we go. All right. Smooth it all out. All right, now
take that
into the oven, right?
Into the oven.
Okay, now how hot does it have to be?
325 degrees.
So it's been preheated to 325, and in we'll put it. And we've already had one that's been baking. And for how long?
For 45 minutes.
45 minutes. Then so after 45 minutes, voila.
You let it cool for 15 minutes, then you cut it into squares.
And there we have it, right? Okay,
right.
Now comes the best part, I get to taste. That may be a little difficult with it. Wait a minute, let's just, there, how's that? Oh, boy, is that good. Oh, man, that is great. Is there another recipe for a cake, or would you consider this a cake?
You could consider it a cake, because it's...
That's the way it comes
right,
out in the pan.
It looks like a cake.
Michelle, thank you very much for giving us this neat idea, and I hope you have a happy Halloween.
You too.
If you would like Michelle's recipe for chocolate chip pumpkin squares, or her pumpkin raisin cookies, or Scott's pumpkin seeds, write and let us know. Jenny?
Dr. Lester Fisher, director of Lincoln Park Zoo, has brought in some Halloween animals in today. Hi.
Hi, how are you?
Fine, how are you?
Well, I'm kind of excited being here for your Halloween show and seeing that makeup everyone
has.
Yeah,
well, we're glad
you
could come.
Well, and I thought that today it'd be kind of special to bring some animals that people sort of relate to spooky things and Halloween. And in front here, the first animal we're looking at is a bat. And this is what we call a neotropical fruit bat. It actually was collected down in Panama by our assistant director, Dennis Merritt, during one of his visits to that part of the world. And animals like this kind of have a, perhaps you might say, a scary history, but they're really not only nice animals, but they're mammals. The important thing to remember is that very few mammals can fly, and the bat is an exception.
Yeah.
There are animals like the flying squirrels that sort of spread their front and back legs, and they have a little membrane between the front and back legs, and they kind of glide down. But the bat is a very specialized animal, and over a period of time, it developed the wings with which it can fly. This particular one is a female, and I think she's pregnant, and will probably have a baby sometime within the next month. Is there anybody you would like to name her after?
Well, since it's bat begins with a B, how about Britta?
Britta Bat.
Britta Bat.
Well, that sounds like a nice name. And in our small mammal house, we have a collection of these bats. And you can come and watch them, because there we reverse the lights. In the small mammal house, in the nocturnal area, we use red lights during the visitor hours, because the animals can't see the red light, so they think it's night.
Yeah.
And to watch them swooping around where the bananas and the other fruits are that are out there is sort of a real experience. Sometimes we think of the big vampire bats.
Oh, yeah.
And some zoos lay on exhibits of that, but we don't have a large space for that. I brought along another animal here that I think will be a lot of fun for Halloween.
Ooh.
It's a heavier cage. Any idea what that is?
Oh.
It's a spider.
Yeah.
And it's a tarantula. And believe it or not, some people are comfortable handling tarantulas because their bite is not necessarily deadly or always going to kill somebody, but they have a venom. Spiders are actually carnivorous animals, meaning they catch other creatures and eat them, mostly other insects, although there are some large spiders that can catch larger animals. And somehow, when the male with certain kinds of spiders gets close and mates with the female, and if he doesn't get away in time, occasionally the female will actually kill the male.
Ooh.
And that's where the Black Widow spider story comes from. I brought along a little surprise here, because I didn't think you and I would want to handle a tarantula on the air. But if I can open this, this is not a live animal. It's a shedding. And I thought it might show. Do you want to hold your hand out? It doesn't hurt, honest. A spider cannot expand as they grow and develop, so just like other reptiles, they actually shed their skin. And what you have here is a shedding from a tarantula spider. And it was just shed
really
in the last 3 weeks. It's probably a female, because the females tend to shed more often and be a little bigger. And so you come and visit all these Halloween kids at the zoo.
I sure will. Well, thanks a lot for talking with us today, and I'd like to thank our tarantulas here in Britta for talking.
Britta Bat. Very, very nice, Jenny. See ya.
Thank you.
You bet.
Art Wall has some sensational artwork that you have sent in for Halloween, and we would especially like to thank the Shaboni Elementary School and the Wood Oaks Elementary School in Northbrook, the Taft Junior High School in Crown Point, Indiana, and Marcus Garvey Elementary School in Chicago. For the great artwork. And we would also like to thank the folks at Wood Oaks Elementary and Marcus Garvey Elementary for the great masks.
Aren't they great?
I hope you've been looking at them throughout the
show. I love
them. Just sensational. Thank you very much. And now, of course, it's mailbag.
Yay!
And let's check in the KB mailbox and see what we get for our special help. A little... Oh, wait a minute. We have something else? Wait, what's coming out? Oh, I see. You plug this in here. Well, you know what this is? It's an electric pumpkin. Yeah. No. How about some jokes? There we go. How about that? Here, I'll give you some and I'll take some.
Okay.
What do you got?
To start things up, here is a joke from Stephen Burrell of the Marcus Garvey School.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, what holiday does a vampire celebrate in November?
What holiday does a vampire celebrate in November?
Thanksgiving. Okay, here's a joke from James W. Sanders, 9 years old, from Gary, Indiana. Why do witches ride brooms?
Why do witches ride brooms?
Because vacuum cleaners are too heavy.
Wow. That's heavy.
Okay, here's a riddle from Lynn Hanna of Chicago. What do you do with a blue monster?
What do you do with a blue monster?
Cheer him up.
Hey! And here's a riddle from Christy Kaiser of Hoffman Estates. What happened when Count Dracula started writing poetry?
What happened when Count Dracula started writing poetry?
Things went from bat to verse. Oh, right, here's a knock-knock joke from Delore Newsome. Knock-knock.
Who's there?
Trick.
Trick who?
Trick or treat. Smell my feet. Give me something good to eat. All right, and finally a poem. This comes from the Taft Junior High School, and it was written by Jenny Kamen. Halloween pumpkin. Here I sit with candle lit burning me inside. So now I know that Halloween finally has arrived. Children come and stare at me as they knock upon the door, hoping for a piece of candy, or maybe two or more. And when they leave, they smile at me and show me all their sorrow. For as a pumpkin, they all know I'll be of no use tomorrow. All right!
Okay, well, we got a lot of requests for actor comedian Gary Coleman's address. Gary plays Arnold on TV's Different Strokes. You can write to Gary and care of Different Strokes, Tandem Productions Incorporated, 5752 Sunset Boulevard, Room 200, Los Angeles, California, 90028. That's Gary Coleman in care of Different Strokes, Tandem Productions Incorporated, 5752 Sunset Boulevard, Room 200, Los Angeles, California, 90028.
All right, then remember, if you have a joke, riddle, picture, or poem you would like to share with us, please send it in. Here is the address.
Kidding Around, WMAQ-TV, 19th Floor Merchandise Mart, Chicago, Illinois, 60654.
Thank you for all those cards and letters.
Oh boy. Well, a big thanks to all of our guests for being with us on our Halloween special, and thank you for joining us, too.
And be sure and have a happy and safe Halloween.
Mm-hmm.
Well, next week, we're going to have a very special circus show. We're going to meet an 11-year-old bareback rider and a juggler.
We're going to see some mimes, some clowns, and lots, lots more.
So be sure and join us for lots more fun on Kidding Around next Saturday at noon.
Happy Halloween! Oh, boy! Come on in here. Forget, if you have a special talent or hobby and would like to be on TV, just write to us. Kidding Around, WMAQ-TV, 19th floor of the Merchandise Mart, Chicago, 60654.